Estimable people, today we will be looking at subject-verb agreement. Some call it Concord, yes. There should be an agreement between the subject and the verb in a statement. In every sentence that we write or we say, this sentence, we always use a subject and that of an object. When we talk about subject, we are talking about the noun or pronoun, about the sentence. When we talk about verb, we all know the action or whatever. But the point is that, with respect to subject-verb agreement, it is majorly important that we should know that there is this relationship, this agreement between the subject and that of the verb in a sentence. So if the subject is singular, the verb should also be singular. If the subject is plural, then the verb should also be plural. That is the agreement we are talking about. There should be this relationship, that agreement between these two important areas in grammar. Now, what do we mean by singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb? What do we mean by that? We will look at all the inflections, because we inflect verbs per the use of conjugation. We'll look at the inflections. But before we do that, let's look at this. Subject-verb disagreement. Before we even come here, let's look at the disagreement. Now, the disagreement here has to do with the noun or the subject being singular and then the verb being plural and vice versa. Let's look at some examples. One. The presence of double S in a statement with respect to the subject and the verb is an error in grammar. And for that matter, it doesn't go in line with the rule of subject-verb agreement. Example. So these examples are all subject-verb disagreement. Now, here we have the presence of the double S. We have the S. Here too we have the S here and that of the S there. Now, it will interest us to know that when it comes to Concord, a noun plus S is plural. A verb plus S is singular. So you see that the two are inversely related. When you add S to a noun, like what we have here, teacher, teachers, it is plural. When you add S to a verb, it becomes singular. So when you add S to this verb, want, it becomes singular. Therefore, we have plural subject, singular subject, disagreement. Plural subject, singular subject, disagreement. Plural subject, victims, then singular verb. It's a disagreement. When you come here to the absence of the double S, render the statement grammatically wrong. So if the two S's are also absent, then there is also a problem here with Concord. Here we have a teacher, and you know, a noun minus S is singular. Then a verb minus S is plural. So if we come here, we have a teacher minus S, a noun, which is singular. We have a verb minus S, which is plural. Then we have plural verb, singular subject. That is wrong. When we come here, a footballer, singular subject, plural verb, is also wrong. When we come to the next one, coronavirus victim, a coronavirus victim, one, singular subject. The verb here is without S, so that's plural. So singular subject, plural verb. When you come here, plural subject, singular verb. This is a disagreement. We expect that the subject should be singular, the verb should also be singular. That is the relationship. That is the agreement. When you come to the next one too, it should be the same way. Therefore, what do we do? It is only one S at a time. So when we come here, for example, a teacher wants salary increment, the S should be at one place. If you bring the S here, then you make this plural. Then you don't bring the S here. So the S should be one at a time. Either you bring the S here and you don't bring it here, or you bring it here, you don't bring it there. So, a teacher wants, a footballer demands, a coronavirus victim recovers, then you've corrected this error, this anomaly. When you come here to, you can either make it teachers want, footballers demand, coronavirus victims recover. So we have plural subject, plural verb. We have singular subject, singular verb, when you add the S to the verbs. So that is what we mean by subject-verb agreement. We'll look at all the inflections. And to substantiate all these that we've talked about, we have statements like speed kills. There are some vehicles, commercial vehicles, when you take them, this, when you bought them, you see the inscription on them, speed kills, so keep your speed. So speed, singular, it kills, singular verb, singular subject, sorry, singular verb. When you go to Leicester City in England, I mean a team in England, their motto, or if you like their slogan, is what they said, foxes never quit. So foxes. Never quit, full stop. Foxes, plural. Verb without S, plural. So if it is a fox, let's say Jamie Vardy, one footballer, a fox never quits. You add the S. That is why we say givers never lack. Givers never lack. Givers, plural. Lack, plural. That is all these. Or a giver never lacks. So that is about subject-verb agreement. Let us now look at the inflections with respect to the conjugations of the pronouns or the nouns and then the verbs as far as subject-verb agreement is concerned. Before we look at the inflections, let us not forget that we also have what we call gender incoherence. I could say that John Dumelo has won the elections. Then, as I continue to replace John Dumelo with a pronoun, I write she, trouble. Gender incoherence is also part of Concord. Because John Dumelo is a male, why should I use she when trying to replace him? Gender incoherence is also part of Concord. Now, quickly, let's look at the inflections that we refer to. The last time we looked at pronouns, so I don't think this is a difficulty. It is not rocket science. It rings a bell in your ears. Now, I am, you are, he is. All of these will be are. And mind you, this am here is just like this are. Because if someone asks you that, or you tell someone that I am a human being, and you want to form the question tag, you can say am it I. You say aren't I. And so this am metamorphosis, it changes to become are. So it's just like the are. So this one is the different one among all of them. If we see this as a, then this one is totally different from the rest. Now the inflection here is that when you have I, it is am. When you have you, it is a. All of them will take a, except the third person. So the rule is that when it comes to the third person, it becomes is. Therefore, any verb that is in line with this, any verb that will fall under he, she or it, I mean the third person singular, will take an S. So it refers, it means, it has any verb at all that will come here, the third person will take the S, but the rest of them will not. That is why when you are defining something, constitution refers to a set of rules and regulations. Archimedes' principle states that when a body is wholly or partially immersed in water, it displaces an abstract, which is equal to the floating, which is float or something. So that is about that. It states that the law of demand states. So the third person always takes the S, while the rest of them will never refer. All the verbs that will come will not take the S, except the third person singular. That is what we mean by the inflections. Now let us look at the various rules as far as Concord or subject-verb agreement is concerned. Now the first one has to do with quasi-expressions, forced conjunctions, and pseudo-glosses. Now, a singular subject that is followed by a pseudo-gloss or a forced conjunction or a quasi-expression, such as well as, no less than, plus, with, together with, etc. Any singular subject that is followed by these quasi-expressions or pseudo-glosses or forced conjunctions takes a singular verb. Examples. Shatawale with Stone Boy has hit songs. Now we have Shatawale, we have Stone Boy. One will say, ah, but we have two individuals here, so it should be they. Therefore, this verb should be have. No. The point is that the introduction of this with something, this quasi expression or forced conjunction or whatever, added to this singular subject, Shatawale, the singular verb is required. So, Shatawale with Stone Boy produces singular verb. As we said earlier, any verb with the S is singular. So it reads Shatawale produces or Shatawale has his songs. Even though with Stone Boy, this expression with or together with plus no less than as well as all of them, when they come, if whatever follow, even if it is plural, the verb will be singular. Because the rule is that a singular subject like Shatawale, which is followed by a quasi-expression, a forced conjunction or a pseudo-gloss like with, as well as together with, the verb that will come must agree with this singular verb. Therefore, this singular subject. Therefore, the verb here should be singular. Let's consider more examples. Obviously, we have together with, the next one too, as well as. Here too, we have including, then the next one we have together with. Now, we realize that Shatawale is singular subject, Pep Gabula singular subject, Mahama, Juliet Ibrahim, Reverend Obofor, these are singular subjects, but they are followed by these expressions called pseudo-glosses, or if you like, forced conjunctions, or quasi-expressions. And whatever follows the quasi-expression doesn't matter. What matters is that once you have the singular subject followed by these expressions, they don't affect the singular subject. Therefore, the singular verb is used. When you come to the next one, Pep Guardiola together with Mauricio Sarri uses the same style. We said that a verb plus S is singular. Therefore, any verb that is plus S is just like is. And any verb minus the S is just like are. So if you have verb minus S, it's are, plural. Verb plus S, singular, is. So if you have something like this, Pep Guardiola, together with Mauricio Sarri, uses, is, has, demands, or reveals. Whatever verb comes here, we take the S, singular. And it comes the next one, Mahama, as well as Nanado, is doing well for the country. Juliet Ibrahim, including all these personalities in Ghana. Nadia Eko, Miss V, all of these people have done something for the country. They've risen the flag of Ghana high in their own ways. Now, but you realize that we are using has as a singular verb, despite the number of names mentioned in the likes of Dumas, Nadia, Miss V, and of course, Nanaba Anamwa. But if you realize that this has is agreeing with only Juliet Ibrahim because of the including. You see, English language is about rules, or if you like, principles, guiding the language. It's not about semantics, meaning. Because someone will say, ah, how can you mention Juliet Ibrahim plus other people? And you are telling us that the verb will not be have, or the verb will not be ah, but you are telling us that it is has or is. That is the rule. So, Reverend Obofor, together with Obinim, just imagine that you have these two personalities, they are powerful. But
we have used together with Reverend Obofor plus Obinim, Reverend Obofor as well as Obinim. Whatever follows together with will be a singular verb. Or any verb at all that will come here will take the S. That is what we mean by quasi expressions being used after singular subjects. That is about the first rule. Now, when we consider the second rule, we are going to use AND, the use of AND, the conjunction AND. So the second rule of subject-verb agreement has to do with a singular subject that has, if you like, or which is included by AND or joined by AND. Two singular subjects that are joined by AND takes the plural verb are. So if you have Shatawale with Stoneboy as the first rule, here it will be Shatawale and Stoneboy. Then this will change to what? Have. Because here, this conjunction is joining these two. Therefore, they have hit songs. Use of the conjunction AND. When we come to the second one, Pep Guardiola and Mauricio Sarri. Use. Because of the AND, this thing will change. When you come to the next one, Mahama and Nanado are obviously Juliet Ibrahim. And here will be what? Have. Then of course, these men of God who also tend to So we have Reverend Obofor and Obinim are powerful. That is the second rule of Concord.